Maharashtra government could soon issue a notification that will make consumer goods companies accountable for collection and disposal of non-recyclable plastics used in their products. The notice could bring FMCG companies under extended producers' responsibility model. Within the next 3 months, companies will have to ensure that there is a system to collect and deposit non-recyclable plastic at collection centers after consumers dispose them. Currently, since these multi-layered packaging items are not recyclable, there are no takers for them. Hence, RAS pickers are paid Rs. 6 per kg if they gather and sell the multi-layered packaging items. To incentivize the rag pickers to collect shampoo sachets and snack pockets, we have asked companies to pay rag pickers at least 12 to 13 rupees and they have agreed to it, said a senior state government official. The state government has decided to allow local grocery stores to use recyclable plastic of at least 50 micron that weigh 2 grams for packaging daily needs. A change of guard in Mumbai police took effect on Saturday with 1985 batch IPS officer Subodh Jaiswal taking over the reins as the commissioner of police from Datta Parsaglikar, who will now take charge as the state director general of police following the superannuation of DGP Satish Mathur. Jaiswal, like Parsaglikar, has had a stint with central intelligence agencies. Posted as additional secretary, Jaiswal was empaneled to the post of DG in the union government in March this year. He has been attached with RAW for the last 10 years. Last year, the state home department wrote to him asking him if he would be interested in returning to Maharashtra. Sources said the appointment was made in consultation with NSA Ajit Dovar. Spiritual leader Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev presented a river rejuvenation plan to Fadnavis during the event. The exercise is expected to increase the green cover in the state from 20 to 30%. Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis launched a drive by planting a banyan tree in Warap village of Thane district. State Minister for Forest and Finance Sudhir Mungantiwar, along with his wife Sapna Mungantiwar, also planted mango saplings in the day. Chief Minister, while addressing an event to launch the drive, said, "Today, tree plantation is no longer confined to government. It has become a mass movement." State Party President Ashok Chauhan told that Congress is attempting to form a grand alliance in Maharashtra before 2019 Lok Sabha elections and assembly polls. He told that Congress was looking forward to tying up with 10 parties including Sharad Pawar's Nationalist Congress Party, the Left, the Peasants and Workers Party of India, Prakash Ambedkar's Bharipa Bahujan Mahasangh and Swabhimani Shetkari Sangathan. The Indian Meteorological Department has issued warnings of cyclonic circulations over Northeast Arabian Sea off the North Gujarat coast at upper levels and East Central Arabian Sea off the South Maharashtra coast in a higher level. With the northward shifting of monsoon trough, weakening of the offshore trough is likely, leading to a reduction in rainfall amount over the west coast. The significant rainfall area is likely to be the southern peninsular region only on second day. The Maharashtra government will bear an annual burden of Rs. 1,314 crores for paying 50% fees of students of medical, engineering and other professional courses whose family income is less than 8 lakh per annum. Of the total amount, budgeting of Rs. 1200 crore for fees related to engineering and other professional courses has already been done. Under the Rashtri Shahu Educational Fee Scholarship Scheme, government bears 50% of the fee burden of students studying in professional courses. Administrative Officer of AISSMS College of Engineering Abhin Bhosle on Saturday lodged a complaint of fraud at Burn Garden Police Station against two students. The duo, who belongs to backward class category, has furnished fake caste certificates to reserve seats and avail concession on fees during the admission last year. The accused have been identified as Karan Pawar, a resident of Pimpal Gurav, and Neelam Kohli, a resident of Nanapet. Pawar and Kohli had secured the seats in computer engineering courses for the first and second years in 2017-18, as informed by Sub-Inspector Devidas Dhole. The offence of fraud has been registered under sections 420, 465, 468 and 471 of IPC for fraud, forgery, purpose of cheating and fraudulently using genuine documents. As per the contract signed by PMC, Swachh has been given the responsibility to pick up waste and segregate it under dry and waste categories. Mangal Pagare, CEO of Swachh, told that post the plastic ban, we have registered a huge spike in the amount of plastic waste generated. The uncompromising attitude of civic authorities against those violating the plastic ban has created a sense of fear among citizens. This has resulted in them throwing a huge heap of plastic waste into the big dustbins placed at various locations in the city.